We're glad you joined us for Middle Tennessee Record. He once graced the sports pages of national newspapers, but few people recognize his name. In fact, he's probably the most famous Tennessee sports figure you've never heard of. John Lynch has the story from Columbia.
He and his horse were the first to break the two-minute barrier and set a new record, but few Tennesseans know the story behind this granite spire in a small park in Columbia, Tennessee. Before there were Tennessee walking horses, Edward Franklin "Pop" Geers was the grand old man of harness racing, a sport that elevated the spirits of Tennesseans in the hard times following the Civil War. Now an MTSU graduate student is bringing his life and his legend into focus with her master's thesis. History major Sarah Elizabeth Hickman, a Columbia native, was steered toward Geers by Maury County historian Bob Duncan, an old family friend.
Bob gave me three folders. I went back to the room and read through them. The light bulb went off in my head when I read the first article that was in the folder, and I decided then that I could do this. There was a possibility that I could write about Pop without any issue. There was enough information in those three folders to get me kicked off.
To find out more about Geers and harness racing, Hickman traveled to the Harness Racing Hall of Fame and Museum in Goshen, New York.
Contacted them, told them what I was doing. They immediately started gathering information for me and telling me what they had, what I needed to look at, and other things. And I could not wait to get up there to look through the stuff. They said, we have the trade publications, we have photographs, we have his racing jacket, we have a sulky, we have this, we have this. And I said, when can I come?
Geers earned more than $1 million in his career. On August 14, 1916, he and a former plow horse named Napoleon Direct broke the two-minute barrier, coming in at 1:59.75. 10 years later, his career met a tragic end. On September 2, 1924, in Wheeling, West Virginia, at the start of the second heat, Geers mare, Milady Guy, tripped. Pop was thrown from the sulky, and one of the other sulkies hit him on the shoulder. He died shortly after that. Hickman, a historian at heart, wants to know even more about Pop. In fact, she wants to publish her thesis as a book someday. But for now, she says, graduating this December with a master's degree in public history is enough.